make sure your visitors pay for your shipment costs, because shipment is just not very cheap these days. I am Matt, aka the WPress Doctor, and we're going to start right now. So during the setup of WooCommerce, you might come across this one, setup shipping. If you want to know everything about taxes, watch this video and I will show you everything you need to know about setting up taxes the right way. But we're going to set up shipping over here. Click on this one. Now the first thing you need to define as a business owner is how much does my shipping actually cost me? I have three web shops, two which sells physical products and one that sells subscriptions, my hosting company. If you look at the paid shipment costs I would pay to all the carriers, almost 2,300 euros. However, when I look at my profit, what I get from my customers in shipment costs, I only receive 1,774. That's a loss of more than 500 euros in shipment costs. And that's okay if you make a lot of profit. So for you as an entrepreneur, you really have to see your web shop. How much does my shipping cost and how much can I charge my customers? I charge 6 euros and 95 cents on my shipping costs for a package, which is very normal in my country. For the rest of the world, we are gonna charge 15 euros. Let's press complete task. Now let's change the shipping rates. Let's go to the settings of WooCommerce and then we go to shipping. In the shipping zone, now they have created a flat rate because we have just walked through the setup. If you're starting out your website with just a few products, you can definitely do this yourself. If you have a lot of products and you're selling to the entire world, then you should definitely make use of a partner which has their own portals, so you can actually print your own labels and everything, and it's all integrated in WooCommerce. That saves you a lot of time and a lot of money. Press on edit on our zone, the Netherlands. Within the zone name, you can actually add regions. So I'm gonna change this to Europe. In the region there is the Netherlands, but we also have Germany and we also have Belgium and we also have Viva La France. Now then you have the shipping methods to all these places, the flat rate, and I can edit it or I can add more. The flat rate is taxable. Let's change the flat rate setting for UPS. And then we can charge 8 euros and 95 cents to send them out to Belgium, France, Germany, and the Netherlands. Actually, this is the west of Europe, but we also want visitors to make them choose to free shipping. But this method will only be triggered with coupons and minimum spends. Why not let add another flat rate, which will be FedEx. And for FedEx, you pay only 6 euros and 95 cents. Why not? Press save changes. Now, I wanna change this free shipping method to there because you will see it during checkout. Then we go back to shipping zones because I don't only wanna send to West Europe, I also want to send to America. So I'm gonna add a shipping zone like this and I'm gonna type in United States. And the regions will be, of course, the United States. And you can even go per state. So if you're living in Alabama and you want to send to Alaska, you would definitely need different zone regions because there are different types of rates. Let's use just United States and you can actually create them yourself. We're going to add a shipping method, of course, a flat rate. And the flat rate will be with UPS and it will be 8 euros and 95 cents. And then we're gonna add another flat rate and it's going to be FedEx and we're gonna charge 6 euros and 95 cents. And then we also have, of course, the free shipping. Sending with UPS, and it's gonna cost us 30 euros to send something from the Netherlands to America. We're gonna cost it 25 euros to send it over there. You can change the order by dragging this around, but you can also disable one. These companies tend to change their rates every single year, and it sometimes really gets frustrated. All right, press save changes. And now we can ship to West Europe and to the United States within this web shop. Let's go to the shipping options. Do you want a shipping calculator on the cart page? If you're just sending to one country and you're using one rate, please disable the shipping calculator because the shipping calculator will actually start to work when you only fill in your address. But if you're just using one rate, it really doesn't matter which address you use because you're just in one country. If you do, however, send to different rates, different countries, different states, then you have to use a calculator or else it doesn't work. And then you can also say high shipping costs until an address is entered, which is useful if sometimes your shipping costs are very low until they say, I want to send it to America, and then they have to quadruple the costs. Let's add it in right now. I'm going to show you later on how this affects the front end. Then the destination is default to customer billing address. I would say default to the customer shipping address because you're paying the shipment cost to the place it's going to be. For example, if a customer wants to have the invoice sent to Europe, but they want the package to be sent to America, what do I have to pay? Of course, the package. So put this on shipping address. And then we have a debug mode, which you can use if everything goes sideways. Press save changes. And last but not least, we have the shipping classes. The shipping classes are really advanced to change your shipping class per product. This is useful if you're, for example, sending out very large products. And the slug should be the same. We're going to use this class for our rocket engines. And we're going to save shipping classes. Also have another class, normal, just all other products. You definitely don't need to fill out the shipping classes if all your products just fit in normal shipping classes. Then this is totally not needed. Because I have set this web shop up to be shipping to all countries, because in general, you can actually change the selling locations to all countries or just a few countries. That's the way WooCommerce says you have to add a locations not covered by your other zones. So you can just press this one and then you can add a flat rate and you can change this to, for example, I'm going to charge 150 euros. Because I've added the classes, you now will see a normal shipping class cost and a very large shipping class cost. For normal, it will still be 150 euros. For the very large projects, they're going to pay $1,000. But you can also do a calculation in these shipping classes. Then you have to type in this, and then an asterisk for multiplication, minus, and then you have the quantity shortcode like this. And there's also more with percentage and stuff. But let's say we're going to do this. Press save changes. And then we have our shipping zones set up. Well, how does it look on the front end? And we have different kind of products. We have plant-based protein, fit shakers. And then we have the subtotal is this one, but we shipping cost, we have to calculate it. So we're gonna press proceed to checkout. And in the checkout, we are going to fill this out and only then we can see the shipment cost. And when we've all filled it out, then you can see that we have the shipping options, UPS, free shipping or FedEx. But let's go to the Netherlands. And now the rate has changed within my web shop. It's only 10 euros and we can also use free shipping. And now when I go back to my cart, you will see that also the shipping has been added over here because of it's already filled in and it remembers it. Now let's say you also want to add free shipping for if someone orders more than I would say 50 euros, because then you have enough profit, so the shipment costs will be covered within the profit. Then you go to WooCommerce, you go to shipping zones, when you want to change West Europe, you go to free shipping, edit it, and then you can change the free shipping requires a free shipping coupon, a minimum order account, or both. Well, I would say a minimum order amount or a coupon. And the minimum order amount should be, in our case, 75 euros. And of course, a coupon, but you can add coupons within WooCommerce. Press save changes. And let's say we're gonna ship to France this time. You will see that we also have free shipping now because the total is more than 75 euros. And I'm gonna remove a few products. So I only have 41 euros. Then you can see that, hey, the free shipping has just been removed from my cart total and also in the checkout. Let's say I'm gonna update my cart with even one more. Then we still not have 75 euros. So it is excluding fat. That is very important to know. Let's add another fit shaker. Now we have enough for free shipping. If you still have questions about shipping and rates, or you just want to say, hey, thank you, Matt, drop them down in the comments. If you like this video and I helped you out, hit that like button so I know I was on the right track. If you want to see more videos about WooCommerce, Divi, or other WordPress related videos, just hit that subscribe button. I really appreciate that. Have an awesome day and I'll see you in the next video.